Hi everybody, I've got no voice, so most of the start of this Vlogmas is going to be silent movie style. This is the day before Vlogmas officially starts. I'm testing out my leg because I'm going to go back to work next week. So I've come to get a couple of things from the shops for my nephew for Christmas and that. And I won't be here that long. I don't want to walk around too long because my leg's sore already. And as you can tell, I've got laryngitis. The end of the year is nearly here. Anyway, let's go to the shops. Okay.
Yourself a merry little Christmas. Let yourself be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, my troubles will be miles away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us. Until then, we'll have to muddle through somehow. So have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Oh my goodness, I'm exhausted. That was mad, absolutely mad. I'm so glad I got here early to beat all the traffic, but it's absolutely hectic now. There's like people trawling for parks and yeah, it's so busy now. I'm so glad I've got that over and done with. I thought my leg wasn't gonna make it, but I got through it and I'm going home to put my foot up, my leg up, and relax. Okay, catch us later.
Just give me back the whip. Let me tell you something. Now, you put on this suit. You represent something that has a great meaning and significance to millions of people all over the world. Now, I could overlook your poorly manufactured jump, or even your ludicrously unbelievable beard, or perhaps your phonily padded tummy, but I will not tolerate public drunkenness. You should be ashamed of yourself. Can I get a cup over here? A very good idea, officer! Hey, wait a minute. Mrs. Walker! Mrs. Walker! Walker! We need your help here!
Wayne's pruning the trees and cutting some grevilleas down off the driveway. And I'm going to wrap some presents I picked up today at the shops for our nephew and have a cup of tea and a fruit mince pie. And it's a bit windy up here, so hopefully it doesn't annoy my paper wrapping. But anyway, we'll see how we go.
Do you
Said the night wind to the little lamb, do you see what I see?
Do you see what I see?
Way up in the sky, little lamb, do you see what I see?
Wayne's propagating some grevillea, trying to get them to shoot because we have to chop the big ones down off the driveway because they're lifting the driveway. So he's just cutting off bits to put in pots to get them to grow roots. And then we'll have lots of plants to put in the yard, or maybe he can take them down the markets and sell them. Suppose we'll keep them up here, or eventually they might go down. That's our little plant hospital down there, and it's cordoned off from Barry the brush turkey with chicken wire, and the neighbours are just having a 21st birthday party or something. So we've got some of our rescue plants up here that the brush turkey tried to take out of their pots, and we have some blueberries ready to harvest. And also our lovely poinciana tree has lots of buds on it ready to flower. I don't know if you can see them. And we have some that have already, oh, there's the butcher bird. Hello. And then we have one here that's flowered. So soon it'll be covered in red flowers all over the tree. And then it'll get these ginormous big pods on it about as long as your forearm that are really woody. And then they'll drop off and yeah, so. Your bird always comes to see what's going on if you can get a free feed. And we have this old dodgy looking laundry basket to put over the top of our flowers that Wayne bought for me while I was away. He bought me petunias, and we've got a purple flower coming. See, if we keep them covered by the basket, then Percy Possum, Petunia Possum, can't eat them, because that's what they've done to the one that was there that was sticking out from the basket. And then I need to fill the bowl up for the possums, so they've got fresh water. And that one there is my money tree that Wayne gave me. It was just a little stick in the ground in a pot. And over the years since we've been dating, and that it has grown into this beautiful plant. It's amazing how fast they grow. And our cactus is about to flower. And when you look at that, the little ants are all over it. What's going on there? Clearly they're finding something tasty on that flower. And we have our peace lily that is on the table where I was wrapping the presents, and that has had to be rescued as well from the brush turkey. Oh, good work, Wayne. Now I just gotta give them a water. Yum yum, Pearl. Oh yeah, she likes that. Sorry to disappoint. Right. Jeez. I think I made a bit too much salad, but anyway. What next, Pearl? I'll get a mushy. Can I have some mushroom? Oh yeah. Oh, yeah, that was the bad bushfires were recently. Okay. One more mushy. Anyone else like raw mushroom for your salad? I do. I don't like it cooked. Yep, but I like mushroom in a salad. Mmm, yum. Yeah, cool. Right, that's that. Yum, avocado. I will put that together till we're about to dish up so it doesn't go brown. That's it. Now, if you don't have yourselves a wrap master for Glad Wrap, you need to get yourselves one. I've had this for years, since I used to work for a housewares company. Oh my god, I've got no wrap left. Anyway, basically, I might have enough. I need to get a new roll. Basically, you just go whoop, and it cuts it. And then it's nice and tight, no tangles. So I've had that one for about 17, 18 years since I used to work for a housewares company in Sydney back in the day. And it stood the test of time. It's brilliant. No more tears when you're trying to put Glad Wrap on things. Anyway, that's all for now. Till Wen cooks the barbecue. Percy, do you enjoy your avocado? Worked out it's a boy. Percy. Now he's cleaning his hands and face. Hi. Time for some cross stitch and watching the paramedic show, emergency show, whatever it's called. And there's a storm brewing outside. So I'm just going to cross stitch while we watch telly.